So in my first video, you learned, as if you didn't know it already, that life is not beige. Now, let me talk about Feng Shui and colors. It's very simple. The way Feng Shui works, it works in a cycle of elements, and the colors are linked with the elements. The elements are the universal elements. You've got the water, you've got the wood, you've got the fire, you've got the earth, you've got the metal, and you've got again the water. So it's five elements that turns and that produce each other. If they don't produce each other, actually they can tame each other or they can counteract each other. Exactly like life, because Feng Shui is about life. The wood is represented by the green, the bright green, the elements of the growth. The wood nurtures the fire. Makes sense? Fire obviously is red, the flame. The fire nurtures the earth. Earth, you will tell me, finally we are authorized to have earthy tones. Yes, only for that. And not too many. Just to nurture, but not to bury. That is exactly what you need to remember. Nurture, don't bury. Imagine, it's like a mother. If she is nurturing, everything is all good. If she's overpowering, overprotecting, it's dangerous for the kid. That's the symbol of earthy tones. Don't overdo it. Then you've got the earth that produces the metal. The metal is gold, it's silver, it's white, it's all these very pure metallic elements. Then again, the metal produces the water, and the water is obviously very dark blues or black. Then, poof, again, the water produces the wood. Et voilà, you've got the full circle of the five elements. So if you want to reinforce one or the other elements, you will add the colors.